सो लेट अस स्टार्ट अनदर पॉइजनिंग, सेलेनियम टॉक्सिसिटी। दिस इज वन ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉक्सिसिटी अकरिंग इन द एनिमल्स। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट सेलेनियम। सेलेनियम एज वी नो इज ए नॉन मेटल एंड ऑल्सो एन एसेंशियल एलिमेंट। रिगार्डिंग सेलेनियम पॉइजनिंग इज कंसर्न, यूजुअली अकर when animals are ingested selenium in excessive amount, either from the plants or by the drugs. Regarding the first report of toxicity of selenium is concerned, Marco Polo first observed selenium toxicity while traveling to China in about 13th century. And he has seen that the animals like horses, their hoofs are sloughing out, cracked and sloughing out, and that was related with because of the consumption of plant in that region. And he told that this may be because of the selenium which is coming from the soil. And later on, it was found that the region where this symptom associated with the horse, the soil was highest concentration of selenium was found in the world. So you might say the Marco Polo was the first who observed selenium toxicity. Now we have to go through silent property of the selenium. So selenium belongs to six group of periodic table. So why we are talking about this periodic table? Because the element is belongs to six, and from the same periodic table number six, and another element sulfur is belonging. So why we are relating these two elements? Because sulfur is one of the most important constituent of amino acid like methionine and cysteine, and therefore this is correlated and important, and because the both are belongs to group 6, so that is why this is important. Regarding oxidation number of this selenium is concerned, the oxidase, because the element belongs to six group, their oxidation number also variable. So elemental selenium and selenide both are possessing 0 and minus 2 oxidation number respectively. And another important point with this two one these two are that both are insoluble in water. So if these two are insoluble in water, means bioavailability is less, so toxicity is less. However, the oxidation number 4 and 6, like selenite and selenate, both are water soluble, and therefore their bioavailability is more because of more absorbability from the gastrointestinal tract, and therefore more toxicity occur. So this is important. And if you are going to categorize the ranking of toxicity, the organic selenium, then which is natural in occurring, that are on the peak of the toxicity because of its solubility and absorbability, and thereafter less than organic selenium is selenite and selenate, that is plus 4 and plus 6, which is about equivalent range of toxicity, then minus 2, and the lowest is elemental selenium. So, ranking-wise toxicity of selenium is concerned, natural organic selenium are peak on the toxicity और हैविंग द हाईएस्ट टॉक्सिसिटी बिकॉज ऑफ इट्स सोल्युबिलिटी एंड एब्जॉर्बेबिलिटी, एंड एलिमेंटल सेलिनियम इज लोवेस्ट इन इट्स टॉक्सिसिटी बिकॉज ऑफ इट्स सोल्युबिलिटी एज वेल एज द एब्जॉर्बेबिलिटी. सो दिस इज अबाउट द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ सेलेनियम. नाउ वी हैव टू गो थ्रू द सोर्सेज ऑफ टॉक्सिसिटी. सो द सोर्सेज ऑफ टॉक्सिसिटी फ्रॉम विच द एनिमल आर गेटिंग द सेलेनियम आर सॉयल, एंड फ्रॉम द सॉयल इट इज कमिंग द प्लांट, देन इट इज ऑल्सो कमिंग इन द वाटर फ्रॉम विच वी आर टेकिंग फ्रॉम द ग्राउंड, देन इट ऑल्सो इन द इन्वायरमेंट दैट इज द एयर, एंड ऑल्सो फ्रॉम द फूड एंड ऑल्सो फ्रॉम द ड्रग. सो दीज ऑल आर द सोर्सेज ऑफ सेलेनियम टॉक्सिसिटी. सो इन दिस द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट इज प्लांट, और यू कैन से द सॉयल. सो इफ यू आर गोइंग टू सी द सोलिबिलिटी एज वी अर्लियर डिस्कस, द ऑर्गेनिक सेलेनियम इज मोर वाटर सेलेबल एंड देयर फोर मोर बायोअवेलेबिलिटी एंड अकॉर्डिंगली मोर टॉक्सिक इन नेचर इन लाइव स्टॉक पॉपुलेशन. रिगार्डिंग सोर्सेस लाइक प्लांट इज कंसर्न, द प्लांट इज डिवाइडेड इन टू थ्री टाइप्स एज पर द टॉक्सिसिटी इज कंसर्न. द प्लांट्स आर डिवाइडेड इन थ्री टाइप एज पर द एक्यूमुलेशन ऑफ सेलेनियम इन द प्लांट इज कंसर्न, एंड दीज आर एक्यूमुलेटर प्लांट्स एंड नॉन एक्यूमुलेटर प्लांट. फर्स्ट द डिवाइडेड इन टू एक्यूमुलेटर प्लांट एंड नॉन एक्यूमुलेटर प्लांट. एक्यूमुलेटर प्लांट आर अगेन डिवाइडेड इन टू टू टाइप्स, प्राइमरी एक्यूमुलेटर प्लांट एंड सेकेंडरी एक्यूमुलेटर प्लांट. प्राइमरी एक्यूमुलेटर प्लांट आर ऑल्सो नोन एज ऑब्लिगेट इंडिकेटर प्लांट, एंड सेकेंडरी एक्यूमुलेटर प्लांट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज फैकल्टेटिव इंडिकेटर प्लांट. सो दिस इज द डिफिनेशन, दिस इज द डिविजन ऑफ एक्यूमुलेटर प्लांट. एंड द थर्ड वन इज नॉन एक्यूमुलेटर प्लांट. रिगार्डिंग द डिफ्रेंसिएशन ऑफ ऑब्लिगेट एंड द फैकल्टेटिव इज कंसर्न, और यू कैन से प्राइमरी और सेकेंडरी इज कंसर्न. प्राइमरी एक्यूमुलेटर प्लांट रिक्वायर सेलिनियम इन सॉयल एट हाई कंसेंट्रेशन फॉर इट्स सर्वाइवेबिलिटी एज वेल एज द ग्रोथ. हाउ एवर द सेकेंडरी और फैकल्टेटिव इंडिकेटर प्लांट डू नॉट रिक्वायर फॉर ग्रोथ ऑफ द प्लांट. इफ यू आर गोइंग टू ग्रो वेयर द सेलेनियम इज लो इन कंसेंट्रेशन, इवन दो दे आर गोइंग टू ग्रो देयर, दैट इज कॉल्ड फैकल्टेटिव इंडिकेटर और सेकेंडरी सेलेनियम एक्यूमुलेटर प्लांट. हाउ एवर द ऑब्लिगेट इंडिकेटर प्लांट रिक्वायर हाई कंसेंट्रेशन ऑफ सेलेनियम इन सॉयल, एंड देयर फोर दिस इज गोइंग टू नॉट ओनली एक्यूमुलेट द हाई कंसेंट्रेशन ऑफ द सेलेनियम इन द प्लांट एज वेल एज फॉर इट्स सर्वाइवेबिलिटी फॉर इट्स ग्रोथ, द सेलेनियम हाई सेलेनियम कंसेंट्रेशन इज रिक्वायर्ड. बट दिस इज नॉट ट्रू फॉर द फैकल्टेटिव. इफ द सेलेनियम इज हाई देन द फैकल्टेटिव और सेकेंडरी एक्यूमुलेटर इज गोइंग टू एक्यूमुलेट द सेलेनियम. इफ द सेलेनियम इज नॉट देयर, इवन दो द प्लांट इज गोइंग टू सर्वाइव और ग्रो देयर. सो दिस इज द मेन डिफरेंस बिटवीन दीज टू. वॉट आर द अदर डिफरेंशियल पॉइंट बिटवीन दीज टू आर यूजली प्राइमरी वन इज गोइंग टू एक्यूमुलेट वेरी हाई कंसेंट्रेशन ऑफ सेलिनियम, दैट इज एज मच एज फ्रॉम 100 to 15,000 पार्ट पर मिलियन सेलेनियम, एंड दिस इज नॉट यूजुअली टेकन बाय द एनिमल्स, यूजुअली नॉट इटन बाय द एनिमल, और यू कैन से अनपेलेटेबल अनपेलेटेबल एंड हैव गार्लिक गार्लिक सल्फर ऑर्डर. सो हैज द गार्लिकी स्मेल. if you smell the odor of the animal in the poisoned animal, selenium poisoned animal, you will find garlicky or garlicky sulfur odor from the breath of the animal, that the poisoned animal. So this is very, very important. And plants are usually unpalatable for the animal. But when there is famine, or if the animal are going to force to eat it, then the selenium toxicity occur, and usually acute type of toxicity occur because of this both usually obligate and facultative indicator plant are going to produce the acute type of selenium toxicity, but mainly the obligate or primary accumulator plant are concerned for the acute selenium toxicity. Regarding the plants are concerned and the species in which the toxicity are occur, like the cattle, livestock, you can say the livestock, like cattle, then the horses, then the sheep, then the pig, these all are poisoned animal by the plant. Regarding the plant which are known as primary accumulator plant or obligate indicator plants are Astragalus species, Stanleya pinnata, then Unopsis species, then the Gylorhiza species. These are the example of primary accumulator. However, the example of the secondary or facultative indicator plants are Artemisia species, Acacia species, Astriplex species, Aster species, Penstemon species, Castileja species. So these species are called facultative indicator plant or secondary selenium accumulator plant. And these plant usually not require high amount of selenium in soil for its growth, but if this is present in the soil, the plant are going to absorb higher concentration of selenium in the plant, and also it tolerate it, and it will accumulate about 25 to 100 part per million of the selenium. So that is going to accumulate, so that is why this is called accumulator plant. However, the last one is usually coming under the grains, then the pasture or other plant. They are usually non-accumulator plant, means they are not going to accumulate the selenium, but the selenium is coming in the plant and usually have or usually accumulate up to 1 to 25 ppm of selenium, and which is going to make the protein like selenocysteine, selenomethionine, and selenocysteine. So this is about the classification of plant which are going to accumulate the selenium are accumulator plant and non-accumulator plant. Accumulator plant are divided into two types, primary and secondary accumulator plant, that about the sources of toxicity of the selenium poisoning. Now we have to go through the other source, that is the water. Water and also the air. In air, the high selenium is coming because of combustion of fossil fuel, because of the coal burning, because of the burning of rubber, because of the municipal waste, because of the paper. These all are going to pollute the air with the selenium. So this is about the water, air, and now volcano. When there is volcano is there, so volcanic gases are usually contain high concentration of selenium, and which is found in the air. So last one about the food. So food is also rich in the selenium, then there is chances of toxicity and usually going to give rise to chronic type of toxicity. And the organ, some organ which have the high concentration of the selenium are the liver and the kidney. And other than that, the meat and eggs are also the rich in source of selenium. So these are the sources of toxicity. Now we have to go through the next heading, the toxicity. How the toxicity occurring in the animal? This toxicity is depend upon the many factors. Toxicity of selenium, toxicity occurring in the animal depend on the many factors. These are the chemical form of the selenium. If this is organic selenium, that is more absorbable, so more toxicity. This is about the quantity of ingestion. If the more amount of selenium is get ingested, this is going to produce more toxicity. Duration of exposure. If the duration of exposure of with the selenium in the animal is for more duration, of course this is going to produce the toxicity. And also the species involved. The pig, you can say, is also one of the most susceptible species with the selenium. If you are going to consider the most toxic form of selenium is selenous acid. So selenous acid is most toxic form of selenium and going to produce the toxicity upon its ingestion, and therefore it produces the fatality or mortality. Regarding the acute toxicity is concerned, we earlier mentioned acute type of selenosis occur usually from the plant which contain higher concentration of selenium, and that is called primary accumulator plant or obligate indicator plant. And also no doubt the secondary is also going to form the acute selenosis or acute selenium toxicity, but primary one is more because of the more amount of selenium is present in the plant. So this is about the toxicity is concerned. Regarding the chronic toxicity is concerned, chronic selenium poisoning is concerned, or this is also known as alkali disease. This is alkali disease. This is occurring because of the small amount of selenium is taken by the animal, which is about 5 to 10 part per million of selenium in the diet for several weeks or you can say the months, and therefore this is going to produce the chronic toxicity in a species like horses, cattle and swine. So this is about the toxicity. Now we have to go through the toxicokinetic, which is equivalent to pharmacokinetic. What it means, which is going to discuss about the toxicant absorption, distribution, metabolism and excretion. So we are going to discuss here about the toxicokinetic. The absorption is concerned, as we earlier discussed, the organic one is going to absorb more, and which is absorbed from the small intestine, and after its absorption, particularly the selenoamino acid is more going to absorb. Also soluble selenium salt are going to be absorbed readily from the small intestine, and after its absorption it will come in the blood or in the circulation, and from the circulation it had to circulate or distribute amongst the different part of the body. Particularly the main organs are concerned are liver and kidney and spleen. Particularly these two are concerned, I mean the liver and kidney. So they are going to be distributed, and more fertility is concerned to these two organ. I mean the liver and kidney, they are going to produce the more damaging type of characteristic concern to the liver and kidney. Not only that, the important property with the selenium is that selenium is also crossing the placenta. Therefore, it will produce the problem with the avian eggs because it enters in the avian eggs, and therefore it will going to produce the embryotoxicity and fetal malformation. So this is important. Regarding its excretion of selenium is concerned, after its absorption, it is mainly excreted out through the urine. After the urine, lesser part is excreted out through the feces. Also, if the concentration of the selenium is higher, this may be excreted out the lungs, and also it will excrete out through the bile. So route of excretion are urine, feces, lungs, and bile. However, the highest concentration of selenium is going to be excreted out through the urine. This is the main excretion of majority of toxicant is concerned. The other important point with the selenium is that this selenium is going to deposit in the skeletal muscle, where this sulfur containing amino acid is present. Why? Because this is going to replace the sulfur. So and not only that, selenium is required for a small amount. So that is why selenium is important for functioning of a skeletal muscle in the form of selenomethionine, and because this is also required for many enzymes, therefore the selenium is essential element which is required for the functioning of many enzymes, also for the skeletal muscle. So this is all about the toxicokinetic. Now we have to go through the toxicodynamics, or you can say the mechanism of toxicity, how this selenium is going to produce the toxicity. So this is mainly produced toxicity by three general ways. So selenium is going to produce toxicity by three general ways. But before going to discuss, we earlier mentioned that the selenium is the essential element, and that is why this is essential component. I mean, selenium is the essential component for more than 25 selenoenzyme like selenomethionine as well as selenoproteins. And amongst these, one of the most important enzyme is glutathione peroxidase, which is a antioxidant enzyme. So this is very very important enzyme which required selenium for it for selenium. This is selenium containing enzyme which is glutathione peroxidase, and also required the protein like selenomethionine. So when the selenium become excess in amount, the selenium is going to produce the essential element get converted into toxic element, and this is going to produce the toxicity in three ways. And what these ways are, this is going to produce direct inhibition of cellular oxidation reduction reaction. How? Because this selenium is going to produce depletion of glutathione. So what is glutathione? Reduced glutathione is an antioxidant. So this glutathione, I mean reduced glutathione, is required as a antioxidant. So when there is deficient of antioxidant occur, I mean reduction of glutathione occur, this is going to produce to form the free radical, and therefore this become very very important. So this selenium at higher concentration is going to reduce cellular oxidation and reduction reaction बाय इनहिबिटिंग और डिप्लीटिंग द ग्लूटाथियोन विच इज अ एंटीऑक्सीडेंट, पार्टिकुलरली द रिड्यूस ग्लूटाथियोन एंड देयर फोर दिस इज गोइंग टू इनहिबिट द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ फ्री रेडिकल एंड दिस इज ऑल्सो एस्केवेंजिंग द फ्री रेडिकल एंड देयर फोर दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एज वेल एज दिस इज ऑल्सो डिप्लीटिंग द एस एडिनोसिल मिथियोनिन सो दिस इज द वन मैकेनिज्म ऑफ एक्शन ऑफ द सेलेनियम टॉक्सिसिटी. अनदर टॉक्सिसिटी विद द सेलेनियम इज कंसर्न एज वी डिस्कस दैट व्हेन द सेलेनियम इज हायर कंसेंट्रेशन द ग्लूटाथियोन लेवल गेट रिड्यूस एंड दिस इज एस्केवेंजिंग एस्केवेंजर पार्टिकुलरली द रिड्यूस ग्लूटाथियोन सो व्हेन देयर इज नॉट found the in the body, I mean the reduced glutathione is an antioxidant get reduced in the body, then therefore selenium is going to form the free radical and therefore this is going to produce the tissue damage. So this is very, very important. And another important toxicity, mechanism of toxicity, the third one and the last one is that, as we know, the selenium belongs to the group 6, as well as the sulfur is also belongs to the 6th group of periodic table of the element. And therefore, because of somewhat the property similar to the sulfur, selenium is going to replace the sulfur containing amino acid sulfur element from the amino acid like the methionine and cysteine. So methionine is sulfur containing amino acid, cysteine is also a sulfur containing amino acid. So this sulfur is going to be replaced by selenium and cysteine also, and therefore this is going to produce the selenomethionine and selenocysteine, and therefore this is going to form the main main organ where these amino acid is required that is get affected with this selenomethionine and selenocysteine. How this methionine as and cysteine is going to form the keratin protein like in hair, like in hoofs, like in the horn. These two amino acid is very much participating in the formation of like hair and hoofs and horn, and therefore when these sulfur containing amino acid get replaced with selenium and form the selenomethionine and selenocysteine, which is going to produce the defective type of the hoofs, and therefore it get form the cracked hoofs. So this is very, very important. So we already discussed this is going to helps the free radical by depleting the glutathione, because this is reduced glutathione is antioxidant, and therefore this is going to produce the free radical, and therefore free radical is going to produce the oxidative damage of the tissue. Therefore this is going to produce the cell death. So we already discussed that this selenomethionine and selenocysteine is going to form the cell participating in keratin formation, and therefore in place of sulfur the selenium get deposited, and therefore it is going to form the defective keratin, and therefore it affect the part like hoofs, like hair, like horn. So this is going to very, very interesting. Also, because of the free radical formation, this is going to produce the lipid peroxidation. So this is very, very important. This is going to produce the lipid peroxidation. Regarding the free radical formation is concerned, this selenide anion is going to produce or participate in the free radical formation. Not only these three activities that we already discussed, this is also decreases the vitamin C or ascorbic acid, and therefore this is going to produce the vascular damage. So this is all about the mechanism of toxicity concerned to selenium or toxicokinetic. Now we have to go through the clinical sign and symptom. So this is very, very important about the clinical sign of sign and symptom of the toxicity is concerned. Regarding clinical sign, based upon the clinical sign, selenium poisoning is converted into mainly two types: acute toxicity and chronic toxicity. Chronic toxicity is earlier divided into two parts. One is called blind stager and another is called alkali disease. So based upon the clinical sign, the selenium toxicity is divided into acute and chronic toxicity. Chronic toxicity again further divided into two subtypes. One is called blind stager and another one is called alkali disease. But nowadays, the chronic toxicity is also called blind stager, subacute toxicity, or subchronic selenium toxicity. This is the new name. So earlier, chronic toxicity is divided into two parts, that is the blind stager or subacute toxicity, and the other chronic toxicity of selenium toxicity is called chronic toxicity and alkali disease. So simply you can say chronic toxicity divided into two types, blind stager and another one is the alkali disease. And now it is divided into this subacute toxicity, also known as blind stager, also somewhere I found subchronic selenium toxicity. So these all are the same and all the symptoms are the same. So that is why we kept here, so there is no confusion with these words. Why? Because anybody can ask the question, write down about the clinical sign about the subacute toxicity concerned to the selenium. Write down about the blind stager selenium toxicity. Write down about the subchronic selenium toxicity. Then you have to write only this. If anybody can ask the question, write down about the blind chronic toxicity or alkali disease, then you have to write down this. So this is the clear cut demarcation. Now we have to discuss one by one. So acute selenium toxicity or acute selenosis or acute toxicity is mainly because of taking of plant which contain higher concentration of selenium and which is that is the only one that is called obligate or primary indicator plant. And no doubt the secondary will also lead to the acute toxicity, but primary is main concern. And as we earlier mentioned, how you should know, there may be chances you will find the smell, garlicky smell. So garlicky smell, one of the important clue to give you, there may be chances of the selenium toxicity. So by this way you have to diagnose the selenium toxicity. So this is because of the ingestion of obligate indicator plant, or this may be because of the drug that is also called iatrogenic toxicity. What is the meaning of iatrogenic? Iatrogenic means the disease produced by the drug or by the treatment is called iatrogenic. So iatrogenic toxicity because of the drug, particularly the selenium containing drug. So this is going to produce the acute toxicity. So acute toxicity, when you have to see in the ruminant, you will the found the symptoms like lethargy means thakavat, unresponsiveness, animal are not going to respond, then the colic, that is the pain of the GI tract, then the blood, then you also found the dark watery diarrhea, also found the dyspnea, difficulty in the breathing. An animal will die because of the this difficulty in breathing or labored breathing. This is one of the important sign of the death. Other sign are also there. There is frequent micturition, that is polyuria, then cyanotic, the mucous membrane become the pale in color, then animal become weak, then the uncertain gait, then the animal go through the recumbency, that is the prostration, and animal will die because of the respiratory failure. And you will find this symptom in the horse, like loss of a peptide, that is anorexia, then the ataxia, that is incoordination, the animal is not coordinated in the movement, then the pain is there, the colic, that is called, then the diarrhea is there, then the difficulty in the breathing, that is dyspnea, then you may also find the fever, and these are the symptoms associated with the acute toxicity. And animal die because of the respiratory failure. So these are the symptoms associated with the acute selenium toxicity. Now we have to go through the blind stager. So blind stager is also, you can say, sometimes the chronic is a type of chronic toxicity, and this is also known as subacute toxicity. This is also called the subchronic selenium toxicity. So this is very, very important. Here one very, very important point concerned to the subacute toxicity is that why the name is the blind stager, because animal somewhat lost vision or less vision get reduced, and a staggering means animal is not movement is not well. I mean, animal is going to strike the object. So that is why this is called blind stager. This disease is blind stager because of the loss, less vision, and also animal is not able to stand well, move well, and going to strike with the object. So that is why the disease is called blind stager. And in sheep, the majority of sheep, you will find the nervous sign, and that is called poliomyelomalacia. Poliomyelomalacia means softness. Poliomyelo means spinal cord. So softness in spinal cord is called poliomyelomalacia, and this is one of the important nervous sign associated with the swine toxicity. So this is very, very important. Very, very important. So the livestock is showing symptom like blind or staggering. So this is very, very important. And why this occur? Because of the intake of obligate type of plant or facultative type of plant, or you can say the primary or secondary type of indicator plant, and also because of the selenium in the diet, taking it for the longer time interval, going to produce the selenium toxicity. And swine, the symptoms are loss of hair. That is very, very important. Why the loss of hair? Only because of the keratin that we already discussed in the mechanism of action, that the sulfur gets replaced replaced by the selenium, and therefore the main raw material of the amino acid methionine in cysteine is not well getting the sulfur, and therefore this is going to produce the alopecia, that is the loss of hair. Also that we already discussed that this is the blind stager, so the animal is not moving well, so ataxia in coordination in movement is there. Then the quadriplegia is somewhat the paralysis, or you can say the pain in all the four leg or limb is called, and therefore finally it leads to the paralysis of the limb, that is flaccid type of animal is going to in prostration and recumbent state, and this is very very important symptom associated with the swine in case of blind stager. And in case of the cattle, the symptom associated with the blind stager is well marked, and this is divided into three stages. In first stages, animal are going to strike the object, that is called wander. Wander means animal is going to strike the things, the object coming in the path. So this is very very important, and also the vision become impaired and a loss of appetite. If the vision is weak and the animal is striking the object, all automatically appetite is going to be reduced. So in these condition is going to later on get pronounced, get increased, and you will found the more pronounced in wandering. And thereafter the leg become weak, first initiated from front leg, then also later on become hind leg also. The front leg and hind leg become weak, and in second stage the vision further get impaired, and in the last stage the limb may get paralyzed, as well the organ like throat and tongue get paralyzed. And here you find the important properties like subnormal temperature, and finally the animal will die because of the respiratory failure. But these stages are not clearly differentiated in sheep, so this is very very important. And now the last clinical sign with this one is chronic toxicity or alkali disease or chronic selenium toxicity, and this is very very important, and this is some type correlated with the Dagnala, because in Dagnala you will find somewhat the symptom is quite related, so this is important there. So alkali disease initially it was thought that is because of the disease is because of the taking of alkaline water, so disease is called alkaline disease, but later on it was found this is the chronic type of toxicity because of the chronic intake of the selenium. So this regarding the species are concerned, the species are cattle, horses, pig, and this is mainly because of taking of non-accumulator plant. So in acute toxicity you have seen mainly because of the primarily indicator plant. However, the blind stager is mainly because of taking of the another accumulator, both the accumulator plant, and this the third one, that is the alkali disease, is concerned with non-accumulator plant, and that non-accumulator plant are usually grains and the grasses that are usually not having the such type of property to accumulate the selenium. However, the concentration of selenium in soil is found between 5 to 40 parts per million. And in grain, you will find in the grain and forages, you will find 5 to 25 part per million selenium. So by taking these over week and month, this will lead to the alkali disease, and signs are very, very important because this is somewhat related to the Dagnala disease, ergot poisoning, you can say also, because the symptom is quite correlated with that. So you have to study these in the differential point. So as we earlier mentioned, this is going to replace, I mean selenium is going to replace the sulfur containing amino acid methionine and cysteine, and therefore no well keratin is formed, and therefore defective hoops are formed, and therefore this is going to produce cracking of hoops. And if the hoofs get cracked, how the animal is going to sustain the weight? So lameness will occur, and a stiffness of the joint also occur, and also loss of vitality, animal get weak, and evacuation, that is you can say the bowel get evacuated, pass out. Also, as we earlier mentioned, because of the loss of the defective keratin, the hair get lost. So the cracking of the hooves, the horn also, and the loss of hair is the very, very important clinical sign concerned to the alkali disease or chronic selenium toxicity. So in horse, you will find the loss of hair from the part of mane and tail, and also the cracking of hooves at coronary band. And therefore, because horse is a running animal, this is going to lose hooves, that is get sloughed out. And if the animal is going to retain the hooves, then the hooves become defective hooves and form longer in size, which is about 6 to 7 inch long. And therefore, the animals like cattle is unable to move. So if the animal is going to move, animal is not going to approach with the food. So if the animal is not going to approach to the food, the animal will die with the hunger thirst, hunger and thirst. This is also going to form the gangrene of distal extremities like ear, like tarsal or carpus end, like tips of the ear, like muzzles, like tips of the tail or tongue. So this is going to produce the gangrene of the distal extremities, and this type of system is also you will find in the Dagnala or ergot toxicities. So this is very, very important. One of the most important pronounced symptom associated with the selenium toxicity is pronounced anemia. So anemia is also one of the important clinical signs associated with the selenium toxicity. Now we have to go through the postmortem finding. So in postmortem finding, we are going to discuss mainly the important one is the chronic selenium lesion, and that is because this is concerned to the hoofs. So this is usually you have to see. Whereas the subacute is concerned in swine, you will find very easily in because of the poliomyelomalacia, because this is very, very common in the pig. And with the acute and subacute toxicity postmortem lesion, you will find the congestion of the organ like liver, like kidney, and other organ also. So these are the postmortem finding you will find in the selenium toxicity. Now we have to go through the diagnosis. So diagnosis is the very, very important. So in case of any toxicant, if you will find that the concentration of the toxicant, any toxicant is higher in the blood, then you will say that is concerned to that particular toxicant. So as well as if the selenium is higher in the blood, then you will say this is the selenium toxicity. And the affected organ is liver, so chronic toxicity produces or affecting the liver. Therefore, the liver infection is also get affected, and therefore we are going to perform the liver function test like ALT, that is called SGPT, AST, that is called SGOT, and also the SDH level we are going to see. And the most important is that reduced glutathione is lower, however, the oxidized glutathione is higher in concentration in the blood. So this is very, very interesting or important that the concentration of oxidized glutathione is increased and concentration of reduced glutathione is reduced in selenium toxicity because of the depletion of the glutathione, because this is required selenium. Now we have to go through the last part of the selenium toxicity, which is called the treatment and management. Regarding the treatment and management of this selenium toxicity is concerned, we are going to treat the selenium toxicity based upon the symptom. And therefore, we are going to treat the patient symptomatically and supportive treatment we are going to give. However, the chelator that we are using for metal toxicity, like dimercaprol, like calcium disodium EDTA, like DMSA, we are not going to give this in the selenium toxicity. So be cautious, because when you are going to give the metal chelator or the drug that used as a therapeutic agent for the metal toxicity, when you are going to use for the selenium toxicity, this is not going to be effective, and some cases this further aggravate the selenium toxicity. Therefore, particularly the dimercaprol, that is also called BAL, British anti-levicide, is going to be contraindicated in selenium toxicity also, because dimercaprol or British anti-levicide or BAL is going to aggravate the or worsen the kidney problem. So therefore, be cautious to use this in case of selenium toxicity. Regarding acute selenium toxicity treatment is concerned, symptomatic and supportive treatment is going to give to remove the selenium from the GI tract. We are going to give selenium purgative, saline purgative like magnesium sulfate to eliminate the selenium present in gastrointestinal tract, because the respiratory problem in there. Then we have to go through the oxygen therapy, and because this is going to deplete the reduced glutathione, then we have to give the substitute of glutathione like acetylcysteine. What is acetylcysteine? Is a substitute for the glutathione, and the dose as a loading dose is 140 mg per kg intravenous, and the further dose is 70 mg per kg body weight intravenously, four time daily. Regarding the subacute and chronic toxicity treatment of selenosis is concerned, we are going to give the high protein diet rich in sulfur, because the selenium is going to replace the sulfur. So therefore, we are going to give the high rich protein diet that is rich in the sulfur containing amino acid, that is the cysteine and methionine, which is very much helpful in the chronic selenium poisoning. As well as if there is a stiffness of the animal occur, for to relieve stiffness, we are going to give the treatment like naphthalene and bromobenzene. In addition to that, we are going to give the drug like the compound like sulfate daily to buffalo as oral administration, and the other substance that are going to antagonize, that are going to inhibit the selenium effect, we are going to give these compound or the drug or the feed like linseed oil meal, like arsenic, like silver, like chromium, like copper, but with cautious. And the most important point is that what are the things that we have to contraindicated in the selenium toxicity are vitamin E and BAL, that is dimercaprol. Why vitamin E? Because vitamin E is going to aggravate the further selenium toxicity, because this is going to produce the synergistic action with the selenium. And why the dimercaprol or the BAL? Because the selenium is going to worsen or increase the damage of kidney, and therefore dimercaprol or BAL should not be administered in the selenium toxicity. So this is all about the selenium toxicity, and in last class of toxicity we are going to discuss the phosphorus toxicity. So this is all about the selenium toxicity. That's all.